Hello. I think my camera's acting weird and I don't know why. So I'm gonna try to stay still because the video's like slow or something. So if I do this, it's gonna look weird. So I'm gonna just stay still so it won't be a lot of this. Okay, so I got more questions. Somebody told me that I act like I'm really excited when I get questions and I like to answer y'all's questions. Can I get excited? I do. I get really excited when y'all leave questions, so go ahead and leave them, and I'll make as many videos as possible. Okay, so my first question is, what is academics like and the EOC at the end of BMT? Academics, you go to class all the time. In BMT, you go to a lot of classes. You do more classes than anything. Like, you hardly think you're going to go to BMT and be outside, get dirty, and all this combat stuff. You don't. You really don't. We shot a gun once. There was not a lot of combat. I got dirty once. Out of 8 weeks I was there, I only got dirty once. And that was at Beast because you have to crawl through the sand. That's it. This is the Air Force, not the Army. Sorry to say. But, let's see. I forgot about to say brain farts. Oh, the EOC. The EOC was pretty easy. We had this guy come in and, like, give us a study, like, he helped us study real quick. And basically, it was super easy. Like, just pay attention in classes and ask for a review, I guess, basically. I don't even remember. I can't even tell you what was on it because it was just so easy. It was little questions like, I'm trying to think of an easy one. It's not, this might not have been a question on the test, but it'd be something like, what side of your body do you hold your hat, your cap, when you're in your blues? Which is on the yeah, so easy stuff like that. You have a book, they give you a book as soon as you get to BMT and you carry it with you everywhere for the 8 weeks. Just study that. You have a lot of study time. When you're staying there waiting for chow or you have nothing to do, study. The test wasn't that hard. I didn't think it was hard at all. I missed like 4 maybe out of 100 questions. So it wasn't that bad. Somebody said they're trying to learn the chain of command. They're gonna give you a sheet for that too. Sorry. They're going to give you a sheet for that, too. They give you a whole sheet of the chain of command with all the people. They give you a list of your chain of command, the people's names. They give you the ranks because you have to learn the rank structure. They give you that sheet, so don't stress it because, honestly, I went to BMT not knowing anything. Sorry, I'm moving. I went to BMT not knowing anything. Like, I didn't know anything about the military, anything about the Air Force, anything. And I did fine because they're going to teach you everything. They assume that you don't know anything. So don't go there stressing, trying to do it. Like, I kind of stressed before I went and I was like, oh my God, I need to learn the Air Force song. Or I need to learn this and that. It's nice to know it. It'd be easier. Not easier. But it's just nice to know it. Because you're going to do it every day anyways. So if you don't know it, you're going to know it. Because you're going to do it all the time. But if you know it, it gives you like a little jump start. It's not a big difference though. I wouldn't stress. Don't stress. Don't stress. Any of y'all that's thinking about going, joining the Air Force, and you're stressed about BMT, don't stress. That's the only thing I was worried about. I was like, I'm not worried to go in the Air Force. I'm worried about BMT. And honestly, don't even stress about BMT. That's the least of your, I would say it's the least of your worries, but it's not as hard as you think. Like, I'm a girly girl. Like, I have class in a minute, and I don't care. I still had on makeup, earrings, and stuff. Like, I'm about to go out. I haven't been anywhere today. I'm just going to class later, and I'm going to have to put on my uniform. Oh, I should do a video of my uniform. That's it right here. See it? My junkie room. It's not junkie. It's just this area here. This area right here just looks junky. That's all my snacks and stuff and my uniform, my hat. This this is the little blue thing. It's a little reflective belt. So when you walk in the street or whatever. So yeah, don't stress about BMT. It's not that bad. It's the Air Force. They have a lot of restrictions now because of all the scandals and stuff. So they can't do too much to you. They can't haze you, so they're not gonna put you in your face that much. It's really, it's more mental. It's more being away from your hometown, the environment you're used to, being away from your family. It's, that was the hardest thing for me. I cried for like 2 weeks because I missed my family. But other than that, or being with the females, that was hard too. But other than that, it's not that bad. Do not stress. But if you have any questions, if you're stressing about anything, let me know. Tell me, ask me questions. Don't feel like you're being annoying. Ask me a million questions. I don't care. Next question. graduation requirements. You just have to pass your PT and your EOC. I wish I remember what they were. I don't remember what the score is that you need to pass. The PC, I mean the East, I mean, dang it. PT scores, I want to say, is like a 90. I made a 95. I feel like it's kind of high, but I feel like it's a 90. The EOC, I'm not sure. That's lower than a 90. But it's not that hard. It's 100 questions, multiple choice. So it's not that hard. But to pass, it's to the graduate requirements are not that bad. Just stay out of trouble. Stay out of trouble, pass your EOC. Pass your EOC, stay out of trouble, pass your PT. Hold on. I think something's coming. Maybe not. Okay. But yeah, it's not that hard. PC, EOC, and stay out of trouble. And pass everything they... I can't think what else you have to pass. It's not hard, though. It's really not that difficult. Somebody asked me, did I get yelled at for my hair? No. Well, actually, yes, I did. I got yelled at one time in the chow hall because my hair, I guess, because it wasn't, this is kind of curled. In BMT, it wasn't curled. It was like straight hair because I couldn't, you know, I couldn't curl or anything. So I think while I was eating, my hair was like, it must have been like this or something. And this big, the scariest guy in the chow hall came up to me. He was like, you better get that hair out of your face or something he said. And he was like really, it was kind of weird. I didn't even know he was talking to me. And I was like, oh my God. But yeah, you can't, you can have your hair like this, but, oh, let me finish that story. So yeah, he was like, you better get that hair out of your face next time you come to this chow hall. I was like, yes, sir. And he left. I mean, he tried to make himself seem big and bad, but that's all he said and he left. Then I get yelled at because I wore my scarf. If you know, a scarf is like where you wrap your hair at nighttime because it keeps your hair from breaking off. So I wore my scarf, and we had a male MTI in the room, in the dorm that day. And he was mad at me, and he was like, what are you doing with that do-rag on your head? I was like, it's not a do-rag. Guys wear do-rags. He was like, you don't see none of the guys wearing do-rags, so why do you think you could wear a do-rag? So he wrote me up for that, and then when my female MTI came in, I asked her about it. She said it was fine, so that's one time I got yelled at. What's the other question? What did I do to my hair? If your hair is like mine, if you have short hair and you don't want to put micros in it or cut it all off, because a lot of white girls, they cut their hair really short because they say it's easier to manage, which if I was a white girl, I would leave my long hair. If you have long hair, I would leave it and just put it up in a donut bun. Like, do not cut your hair. A lot of white girls did it, and I just wouldn't recommend it. But if you just want to do it because you wanted to, that's fine. Black girls, a lot of girls came, well, like two girls, they came with cornrows in their hair, but they took it out within the second week because it gets really frizzy and really dirty really fast, and it's not going to last. A lot of girls think they can go with braids and it's going to last. It doesn't. So I would recommend just try to, well, what I did, I washed my hair once a week. I did get to wash my hair. So I washed it once a week, and then I washed it, and I put in leave-in conditioner. I have Motions. I'll go get it. I'll go show you what I got. Hold on. Okay. I got little travel size like this big, but I only have the big ones now that I'm here. But I went and got this travel size lotion, Motions lotion. Motions Lavish Conditioning Shampoo. I got this in a little travel size. They have them at, I believe I got them at Walmart. Maybe Target, but I think Walmart. I got a small one of these. And then I went and got, they might have these in travel size, but I didn't see them. So I got a regular size nourishing leave-in conditioner. And then I went and bought an empty travel thing and put it in there and took, I left this at home because it's too big. So I just put this into a smaller one and took down the airplane. Then I went and got this, which is a travel size, foaming wrap lotion from Motions. And I took that with me so I would wash my hair with the shampoo. And then I got out of the shower, you know, patted it down a little bit. And then I would just soak my hair in the leave-in conditioner. Then I would wrap my hair how I wanted to. I'd wrap it around here. And I'd wrap this side to the back just because that's the way I like it. And I smoothed down this part. And I put the wrap lotion all over it, brushed it out, made it smooth, and then I put my scarf on it and made it lay flat. So, and then I would go to sleep on it. So by the time I woke up, it was flat and dry, and that's combed it out. And it just kind of, it worked for me. I never did that before, so it was kind of experimental, but it works out. It works. So I would recommend to do that if you have short hair like I do. If you know how to give yourself a relaxer, that'd be good, because like the 6th week, I gave myself a relaxer in the dorms, but I had a black female, MTS, so she understood, so she let me do it. I'm not sure if all MTS will let you, but just ask. I mean, couldn't hurt to ask. And I also went to the salon at the BX. Some girls in there, and this one girl, she got a relaxer from there. So you could do that local on the weekends, like on a Sunday, probably Sunday, they'll let you do it, possibly. So I recommend to do that. And you can get haircuts also. They let you get a haircut. So that's how I kept up with that. I did my hair for most of the time until like the 6th week. I relaxed it myself, and then I went and got it cut, because this was getting too long, like it is now. Way too long. So yeah, I got that cut. But that's what I recommend. If you have longer hair, I'm not sure. I mean, I guess you could do the same thing. Still wrap it and put the foaming lotion on it, and then comb it out, and it'll work. It should work. Like I said, white girls, I recommend you just keep your hair. Like, don't cut your hair. Don't feel like you have to lose your femininity. That's another thing. Before I got to the Air Force, I thought I was gonna stop being a girl. Like, I was scared that I couldn't be a girly girl and wear my lipsticks and my makeup and my earrings and stuff. But don't let it change you. Like, the Air Force should not change you. You can do what you want to do. You can't wear makeup in there. You can't really do your hair like you want to. You can't wear jewelry. But when you get out, you can. Or while you're in there, do things that make you feel like a woman. Like, I would pluck my eyebrows every weekend, or I'll just play with my hair to make me feel like a girl still. Cause you're wearing like ABUs and you're around, you do start to not, that you feel less of a woman. I did anyways, but I didn't let that stop me. So do not cut your hair if you don't want to cut your hair. If that makes you feel womanly, keep your hair. Like, you can deal with it. They don't make you cut it. They do not make girls cut their hair in the Air Force. Don't let nobody tell you that, because they don't. Only if you have, like, if your hair comes to here or something, and it's not really long enough to put up in a ponytail, it cannot touch your collar. You can't touch the bottom of your collar. Like, if you have, I'll show you. This is my ABU top. So when I'm wearing it, or when you're wearing it, this is the back collar of your coat. When your hair is on, when your hair is down, it can't come to the bottom of this part. It can touch here at the top, but can't touch the bottom. I don't know if it'd be easier if I put it on, but trying to show y'all. Your hair cannot touch, can't go past here. Well, not here, but in the back. It can touch here. Your hair can touch here. It can't touch here. So, yeah. So, if your hair is shorter than that, then you're fine. You can wear your hair down, put your hat on, and look fine. So, any more questions, just let me know. Like I said, I'm excited. I like to answer y'all's questions. So, see you later.